Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trofunet and welcome back to The Witcher 3 on the Deathmarch difficulty. Since we have finished a large portion of the main quest lately, we've also been indebted to a few characters, namely King Radovid and Vern Roche. And today we're gonna start by returning those favors. But first, these halflings that helped us get the dandelion back need our attention.
We are grateful that we wanted to demonstrate that. So, we got this wee gift for you.
A wee gift?
Ooh. Portrait of the Hierarch. Nice.
There's nothing really. Got oodles of them. Just, if you wouldn't mind not mentioning where you got it. Alright?
Alright. Farewell.
Okay, so they're being a bit secretive. Was not about the booze in the cellar, but more about the artwork that we saw. My mistake. So, first off, let's start off with the an eye for an eye quests to return the favor to Roche. So, let's meet him at the camp at Oxenfurt. So back at the encampments of the Temerian guerrillas. It's also a bit strange that these guys are Temerian guerrillas, but Roche seems to be buddy-buddy with the Redanian king, King Radovid, the crazy guy we're gonna see in the next episode probably. So, hi Roche, what did you need me for?
Geralt of Rivia, safe and sound.
As always.
Mentioned you have a problem.
It's Vess. She took a couple of lads across the river. She plans to hit the Black Ones at Mulberdale.
So, sounds about like what guerrilla fighters do.
Yes, when they're ordered to. Whereas I forbade her from leaving camp. Indefinitely.
Okay, what did she do wrong?
Don't trust Vess anymore?
Bollocks. She's prepared to die for me. Ah, that's not the problem. Know what distinguishes a soldier from a common swashbuckler?
The uniform.
It's a serious question.
Following orders, probably.
A rhetorical one. So instead of waiting for an answer, just enlighten me.
Soldiers think tactically. They know when to strike, when to fall back, when to charge and when to hold. Vess finds this difficult. She's impulsive, hot-headed. Yet in guerrilla warfare, one false step and you're fucked.
Sounds like her, though.
I confined her to the camp because I feared that sent out she'd go rabid and make a mistake. I was right.
Okay, so what can we do? So why should... Maybe ask him first why she did go to that village, in spite of her order not
why
to.
Why Mulberdale? Why'd Vess go there?
The peasants from the village aided us earlier. The Nilfgaardians learned of this. Word got out they're planning a punitive expedition. Probably hang every fifth villager.
Honestly, Vess's desire to save the villagers makes sense. What doesn't is your opposition to the plan.
War means death. Not only for the soldiers, for the common folk as well.
Oh, you're a nice guy.
We can't save them all. It's that simple.
Funny. Had you for an idealist.
You were right to. Are right to. But I have one ideal. A free Temeria. And I'm prepared to sacrifice anything for it.
Even poor villagers that helped you out earlier. Okay, what can I do?
Alright, so you've got a problem. Insubordination. What am I supposed to do about it?
I doubt Vess has entered the village. More likely she and the boys lie in wait in the woods nearby. We must find her before she attacks and stop her.
That's convenient.
You're a good tracker.
That she hasn't attacked yet.
Help me.
Okay, let's do it.
Count me in.
Thanks, Geralt. I'll owe you a favor.
No, I
Meet
thought
me
I owed you.
The Hanged Man's Tree. It's just a short jaunt from there to Mulberdale.
Yeah, we've been to that tree a few times, so let's get into it straight away. So it is kind of weird indeed that Roche, well, started to change and doesn't really care about civilian casualties anymore as much as he did before. So let's go. Okay, so back at the lovely Hanged Man's Tree. I'm gonna first make a quick save. There we go. And let's talk to Roche. That's not a really nice place to meet now, is it? Wow, the moon is big in this place.
It's the village below. Black with Nilf guardians already. They're preparing to execute folk.
Yeah, we've been there already.
She may be impetuous, but she's not stupid. She's waiting for her moment. Probably attack after dusk once.
Shh.
What now?
I think he hears them.
Lightly equipped, sneaking closer. Over there, near the...
Death to the Black Ones!
Looks like we're too late.
Well, that's a problem.
Geralt, we have to help.
Yeah.
Follow me.
I'm following. How did you hear that from that far away? Are you there, Devil? Okay. I am gonna, since it's all humanoids, add some appropriately named Hanged Man's Venom. There we go. Okay. There's a lot of dudes here. I think my sword is broken. So, Vest seems to be in serious trouble. Okay, and I am too. Fuck. Okay, this is gonna be hard. So, died to save a woman. I can't think of a more honorable death. But we now know that we need to save Vest as a priority. And if we should go the way that Roche is going, we probably wouldn't even get there in time. So let's help her out here, should we? There we go. Okay, why the fuck is he attacking me? Thank you. He doesn't give a fuck, does he? There we go. And off with his head. So, Vest, are you gonna stay here? Because you're gonna die otherwise. Let's take out the archers here first. Ooh, and another head gone. Whew, okay.
God damn it, Vess. Have you gone completely mental? You ignore my orders, go off on a suicide mission, and instead of donning a breastplate, you dash into battle, shirt open, navel and...
Thank you for finally acknowledging that.
You're not my father, Roach. You've no right to tell me what to wear.
But I am your commander, and you will obey me. Guerrilla warfare. Warfare! It involves armies, for fuck's sake.
I could not abandon them. They helped us.
She would have died if I wouldn't have entered from the other side.
If that is not to your liking,
no pun intended, though.
Study to be a healer. Fucking hell. Give me your weapon. You'll get it back when you wise up. If you wise up. Move out.
Oh, there seems to be one still alive. Is it the one that I took his head off? Huh, one left.
One left.
You took my weapon, Roach. So I must manage with my bare hands.
Leave him alone. There are corpses enough here.
What?
You heard me.
I did, and I can't believe it. He came here to murder civilians. He's seen us. Will you have him return to his camp and report?
Emir knows we can kill his men. Let him learn that we can also show mercy.
That's pretty honorable. But we don't want to leave information about the camp here now, should we? Although they wouldn't know that, would they?
Roach is right. Besides, killing a defenseless...
What is it with you, Roach? Did the Witcher take your stones? They're sadists. He's the occupier.
I will explain later. You, Nilfgaardian, piss off.
Morentai. Nes dirmad ava.
Go, before I change my mind.
Okay, he seemed friendly enough. Roach's sword is just floating there.
Thank you, Geralt. Ever need any help, you know where to find me.
Yeah, I do. And hopefully nobody else does. So that was Roche's favor. An eye for an eye completed. So I'm gonna check my quest log to see if I can't do anything else in the meantime. So I've checked my quest log and I think I'm gonna do this next Witcher contract about the Apiarian Phantom. I think you need to pronounce that. And for that we need to head to the outskirts of Novigrad to Holofernes Meyersdorf. I think he owns the Honeymead factory, if you want to call that a factory. So see you there in a second. So we're at Meyersdorf Meadworks. So that's what he uses the honey for, apparently. It's a pretty nice place. So let's see what this Apiarian Phantom is that he's having trouble with. So that's the door. Let's enter. And then over here, I assume, they're halflings. Franklin Meyersdorf. There we go.
Yeah.
Oh no. Holofernes Meyersdorf. There we go.
Holofernes.
Loving the mustache.
At your service. Meet my sons, Bernie, Franklin, and Hugo.
Any relation to Rico Meyersdorf?
Yes. My youngest son. Sadly, he fled the family business. Went to seek fortune in the big city. Why do you ask? Do you know him?
Kind of.
Well, yeah, we've met. But that's not why I'm here. Came about the notice you posted.
It's the Apiarian Phantom. It's ravaging my hives.
I pronounced that correctly. So let's talk about my reward first.
As far as my reward's concerned.
He has... a pretty nice business, so I'm assuming I can go pretty high here. So let's start at 300.
Honeyfill's not been generating the revenues of old since the Phantom appeared. Would you be willing to reduce your price?
I might be. So let's talk 280 then. Oh, there we go.
As you wish. Fail to rid us of the Phantom and we'll go belly up anyway. I shall look upon your fee as an investment.
So it's
as you should.
It is. It is.
Thank you, Mr. Meyersdorf. Can you describe this phantom
you
to me?
You do realize this Apiarian Phantom. Well, there is no such thing. It's a monster, gotta be. A wraith, maybe. Any of your workers see anything?
I did. I was cleaning a hive when I heard a farmhand cry out. Screamed as though he'd been stung by a whole swarm all at once. I ran to him, but he was dead.
Ooh.
Any stings on him?
None. He looked like he had frostbite. Blue lips, frost in his hair, and dead bees lay all around him.
That's strange.
Farmhand who died. What did you do with the body? Wouldn't mind a look.
Too late for that. We buried the poor fellow a few days back.
Maybe we can do something about that, but where did this phantom appear?
Where did the phantom appear? Can any of you show me?
I'll go. Come with me.
Okay then.
Oh. This way. Follow me.
Where'd you get the idea it was an Apiarian Phantom?
It's a beekeeping superstition. Who mismanage the bees' offerings, the Phantom appears. He destroys the hives and kills the bees, so that no one can use these noble creatures for ignoble purpose.
Sicked your bees on the competition, eh?
No. Father recently signed a contract with the Redanians.
So the Phantom's from Nilfgaard.
Okay, then. Interesting. Do the Nilfgaardians even have that kind of magic? So this place is pretty, though. Okay, Franklin, show me. Look how he's walking.
This is the place. Here's where the phantom killed the farmhand.
Maybe it left some tracks.
Okay, let's take a look around.
Became a witcher, eh?
Okay.
Covered in frost. Cold must have killed the bees.
It's indeed covered in snow and ice. We've seen that before when we were dealing with the wild hunt.
Blood. Dried and blackened, so several days old. Must be where the farmhand died.
So maybe one of their hounds got loose?
Skinflints riding skinflints to skin other skinflints.
Okay, so it went into the water. Maybe I should activate it over there because it seems to not be working.
The Ethereum Phantom's got a large food to lead me, and it's pretty damn heavy.
Pretty damn heavy. So, let's follow the footprints.
Tracks disappear in the water. Doubt anything's hiding in this puddle they call a lake. Need to check the other side, see if the trail goes on.
Look at this! There's treasure here. Thank you. There are a lot of drowners on the coast. Came from over there, so if he walks straight ahead, he should go that direction. But that does mean we're gonna have to fight some drowners. Oh, what? Oh, over here. But I'm gonna have to fight those drowners first.
Show me a pond, and I'll show you the drowners.
The drowned dead are a bit of a tougher version of the drowners. Not that I can't cut them in half like I did the other drowners. And we leveled up! There we go. I think there's one left. Yeah, over there. Oh, there's a few left over there. So let's quickly loot these guys. Water essence. So let's ignore those other drowners and start following those footsteps again. Okay. We're going in this direction. Let's eat a bit and prepare accordingly. We're going in the direction of this structure here. Oh, there seems to be a cave down here as well.
Through here. Gotta find another way in.
Oh, it caved in. It does look like it's all iced up down there. So whatever is hiding down below is probably our target. Let's see if there's anything inside this building, though. There's a door down below, so that's probably where we're headed. There's a lot of barrels here. So before we go in, we might as well level up first. So level 17, let's complete our Poison Blades skill. That adds 25% to poison duration and a 15% chance of poisoning if we use the correct oil. So that's very handy. So let's quen up and enter this place.
It's locked.
Yeah, no shit, Sherlock.
I got the key right here. The father began building this house for Bernie, but ran out of coin. It's been standing half finished since.
Wonderful hiding place for whatever destroyed your hives. I'm going in. You go home and bar your door. Who knows what might come out of there.
Did he teleport you the key? But it's apparently saved automatically, so unlock this. Holy...
Ethereum Phantom my ass. It's a hound of the wild hunt. How the hell did it end up here?
Okay, and ran away, apparently.
Roach will run you down.
Okay, I need to run him down, apparently. I never done this quest, so might have to chase this thing around.
God damn it! This is not as easy as it looks.
Someone help! Help!
What the fuck? How the hell do I even hit this thing?
So let's get off. Get out your sword, Geralt! So I'm gonna quickly check the bestiary for the Apiarian Phantom. It is vulnerable to fire, so the Igni sign is great against it. And the Dimeridium Bomb will also help. And Elementa Oil, so let's see if I have that. So there we go, Elementa Oil. And let's get Igni equipped. There we go. Fire. Now let's finish him off with a Dragon's Dream Bomb. That's very nice. And Igni him again. Yeah, that should whittle him down. Okay, fuck off. So, the Apiarian Phantom appeared to be a hound of the Wild Hunt. So let's loot his mutagen and his trophy. Off with his head. Dance till you're dead. There we go. Nice and smoochy. Let's head back to the apiary, the meadworks. And tell Holofernes that we've killed his annoying hound. Mr. Myersdorf.
Stop plumbing. Your Apiarian Phantom was a hound of the Wild Hunt.
Eternal fire! Hounds run with the Wild Hunt as well.
Yeah, and they're pretty
About
ugly.
2 weeks back, I woke suddenly in the night, saw the hunt streaking across the sky.
Hound must have gotten separated then. Couldn't go back, so it hid in the empty house. It's hardly compensation for your losses. But at least the hound won't destroy any more hives.
Thank you, Witcher. It's true. Nothing like hiring a specialist.
Thank you, little fellows.
Enough, and with that...
Well, I couldn't agree with you more enough for today. So I'm gonna take a little break in this lovely place. Look at this, it's so pretty with all the flowers. So the Apiarian Phantom defeated. Vernon Roche has been helped out as well. So, if you like this video, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you enjoyed the channel by now and you haven't yet subscribed yet, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it if you do. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next episode, where we'll help out King Radovid with his little Philippa Isleheart problem. So thank you guys again for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye.